Okay, now on to the exciting next act. La prochaine présentation sera de une ancienne membre du cabinet, une députée du Parlement provincial. You guys know who we're about to hear from? Mitzie Hunter!
From Mitzie Hunter's riding of Scarborough-Guildwood, please welcome the students of Sistema Choir.
Wings got torn and the sky looks so far. That's the Systema Choir, whom we know very well at TVO because they sing the national anthem at our annual TVO gala. Well done, kids. That's great. We're about to hear from Mitzie Hunter. There'll be a short video presentation before she gives her speech. Mitzie Hunter was one of those very, 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 very few Liberal MPPs who survived the last Ontario election. She won her riding by just 74 votes. And it looks like, are we getting Leo? Are we getting a second number here?
One more number.
Okay, that's Leo Lehman, who we'll speak to in a moment as well, the deputy campaign manager for Mitzie Hunter. Let's hear Systema one more time. From Systema. Leo Lehman is here, the deputy campaign manager for Mitzie Hunter. Leo, what's her mission in this speech?
Well, it's going to be to tell her story and to talk about what she's talked about during the campaign, not just her own biography and history, but the change that we think that the province needs.
Let's listen to the video and we'll come back and chat later.
My parents had big hopes for my brothers and I. And that's why we immigrated to Canada from Jamaica. What I learned from my dad was innovation and how to work hard and to take advantage of opportunity. He created a business, Hunter Mobile Truck Wash, which later his brothers ran. My mother was elegant and refined. She was the heart and still is of our family. When I became education minister, this was big in every way. It was also exhilarating. I am at my best when I'm doing system thinking. That's what public education is. When we lost government in 2018, that was crushing. I remember making the first call to gather the remnants of our Caucus of Seven, knowing that we needed to rise again. We picked an interim leader, John Fraser. We've all stayed close and punched above our weight. I've been inside the legislature all night long when people came to the grounds to protest the frivolous use of the notwithstanding clause. I've also walked alongside education workers, thousands of them, at Queen's Park as they circled around and demanded that Ford not cut public education. During this journey, I've visited over 80 ridings to listen and learn from the people across this province. I see Ontario's potential. Our province and future is in your hands. This government is not listening. We will make them. I represent the change that we need in this party and the province. Our province and our future is in your hands. We can't look to someone else to solve it.
I'm Mitzie Hunter. I'm ready to build a stronger Ontario. Let's be bold together.
That's the Mitzie Hunter video, and now here comes the Mitzie Hunter speech. And I don't mind saying, here at the International Center in Mississauga at just 10 o'clock in the morning, there's a beat to this place.
Yes, indeed.
It's pretty good, Leo.
A lot of excited people here. Yeah.
Mitzie Hunter is 48 years old. She has been for the last, I'm going to say what, 5.5, 6 years, the MPP for Scarborough-Guildwood. She won the last election by 74 votes, was one of those seven surviving Liberal MPPs from the last Ontario election. The caucus now sits at 8. And here comes Mitzie Hunter. No podium. Out there on the middle of the stage.
Thank you so much.
Her pitch to delegates.
Thank you, Sistema Toronto. You represent the hope of this province, from my riding of Scarborough-Guildwood, Sistema Toronto! Good morning, everyone. Bonjour, bonjour. What a fantastic day it is today. Are you feeling good? I want to speak to you today about connection, about hope and change. Je veux vous parler aujourd'hui d'unité, espoir et changement. One of my fondest memories I want to share with all of you. It's really close to my heart. It was going out on the road with my dad as a little girl. I would ride along with him in his big Mack dump truck. And of course, it was red. We would head east from Pickering on the 401. And as we drove, endless farmland was ahead of us. And of course, my dad had strapped me in tightly into the seat. But I was peering over those big windows, looking out. So much abundance in this province. And as we drove, I would notice along the side of the road, there were kids from the farmhouses, and they were standing along the side, and they would pump their arms up and down. And eventually, my dad would blow his truck horn. After noticing, I was about 6 years old, so after noticing this for a while, I said, "Dad, why are they pumping their arms up and down?" And he said, "They want the truck drivers to blow the horn. It makes them happy." And I agreed. You know, my dad noticed those kids. He included them. He connected with them. It was about belonging. Being a truck driver was my dad's dream. My mom financed my father's first truck from money she earned working at an auto parts assembly plant. They did that together for our family. In those days, it was possible. So on that day, in my father's truck, I felt connected to those people. I felt a sense of belonging, of connection, of possibility. I'm here today because of hard work and education and dreams. And I'm on this stage and I'm in this race because I want everybody in Ontario, no matter where you start, no matter who your parents are, no matter where you live, I want everyone to feel that sense of connection to one another and the sense of hope for the future. But you know, these aren't hopeful times. You know, if you look around, you'll see that too few people are thriving. Too many people are struggling. And all around us, there's polarization and a sense of division. And sadly, no force is more polarizing than the current Ontario government and its leader. 2 years ago, Doug Ford told us that he was for the people. But he has governed for insiders and friends. He's cut the things that Ontario value most, like healthcare and education, without cutting the deficit. He'd rather waste millions fighting Ottawa than fighting climate change. He's more concerned about getting standing ovations than about people standing in line for the morning bus. You know what I mean. He is so scared of the media that he created his own fake news network. He is so afraid of getting booed by ordinary people that he canceled Canada Day celebrations. His idea of economic development is putting up signs at the border. But if you have one of his license plates that he just produced, you could get stopped at the border. But we shouldn't be surprised. Doug Ford pretends that he is a populist, but he governs for the powerful. It's hard to say that you are for the people when you are not from the people. Yes. As Ontario Liberals, you and I are here today because we know it doesn't have to be that way. I was in Ottawa, standing in solidarity with teachers. With teachers and education workers who are out protesting the cuts to public education. It was minus 20 degrees. It was minus 20 degrees. Listen, the beards on men's faces was frozen. There were icicles. And their mustaches, even in people's hair. But they were marching anyway. I met a teacher, and her name was Ashley. She's a kindergarten teacher. And I asked her, why is she here? And she said, I love what I do. That's what Ashley said. She says, I love what I do, and I believe that she is making a difference in the lives of her students. For some, what they see are people marching and fighting against the conservative government. But what I see in Ashley is a person for quality education because she cares about the students and all the students. Same way that I honor Ashley and teachers and education workers like her, I honor the children and the young people who were marching in the streets in this province because they know there is a climate crisis and they are fed up with the inaction of this government. But it doesn't have to be this way. I understand the anger and the frustration of people who see public services disappearing from their communities, and they are watching their quality of life go down, no matter how hard they work. But it doesn't have to be this way. As Liberals, we have a duty.
Yes!
We have a duty to do things differently. And we have a responsibility and an opportunity to do things better.
Yes!
That's why I want to lead this party. And that's why I want to lead this province. And that's why I am in this race. That's why I am in this race. Because. Thank you. Because I believe this province can be a place where, like my parents, if you work hard, you can put food on the table. You can put a roof over your heads. Your kids can go to good schools and get good jobs. We can do this together. We can do this. So in this campaign, my team and I, we've talked and we've been very passionate. And I want to say thank you, team, because we've talked about the change we need. We have articulated the change we need in this party and in this province. We need a new liberal economic and social vision and environmental vision for the future of this province. And I believe, and you know this, that it all starts with education, because it is the key to both economic and social progress, to giving people the skills and the talents that they need to get ahead, and to avoiding the costs, the steep costs to society when they fall behind. Our education system is not perfect, but it is built with intelligence and heart, and we can make it better. Do you believe that? Yes. We can make it better. Yes. By investments, we can drive up graduation rates. We can close the achievement gap for Indigenous youth, for Black youth, for LGBTQ plus youth, and for students with disabilities. And as the old economy declines, we need to invest in the new, in research, in innovation, and in high growth companies helping startups right here in Ontario, not just in the South, but in our great North. We can create incentives and programs to build more affordable housing so millennials don't have to pay half their salaries in rent. We can build transit to connect people to jobs and schools and services in both our urban centers and our rural communities. The Ford Conservatives, they try to deceive people. They try to say that you have to choose between the environment and the economy. As Liberals, we know that these two things go hand in hand. We can fight climate change with a Made in Ontario carbon pricing program that returns 90% of proceeds back to citizens. And the other 10%, we can invest that into carbon neutral technology and helping industries and communities to transition. It can be this way. So today, we will elect a new leader for the Ontario Liberal Party. Let's pledge today, all of us, that we will become a new party, a party where there is true democracy and strong governance, where every member has a voice that is heard and valued, and where people feel like they belong. A party where everybody's contribution, from donations to door knocking, is celebrated. To policy, we welcome and celebrate a party that is relevant to all Ontarians, from stay-at-home parents to students and teachers and education workers, from business people to tradespeople, from those who start the businesses that make us wealthier to the public servants that make us healthier. A party that governs Ontario for Ontarians. Let's, Ontario Liberals, let's do this. There is so much potential in this province. And as we begin a new decade, we must not only accept change, we must embrace it. We must drive it. We must lead it. Do you agree with me? Because I want you to know, the time for looking in the rearview mirror has passed. I am laser focused on the future and the road ahead. I am committed to leaving this convention as one member of a united Liberal team, committed to leading Ontario the real change that we need. On Monday morning, thanks to the amazing people of Scarborough-Guildwood, I will be in the legislature, and I will be standing up to Doug Ford, and I will be standing up for Liberal values. Listen, this leadership election is happening on the eve of International Women's Day. And I believe that we need to take action to create the change that we need. That is the only thing that causes change. So, throughout my political career at Queen's Park, I've stood up for women. Just last week, in fact, we reversed the cuts to rape crisis centers. That was something that I fought for. And I fought for that because these are some of the same values that I learned from my parents all those years ago. By connecting people and not dividing them, by listening and learning, by working hard and harder if you have to, and seeing the potential and the possibilities and dreaming big dreams. Big, big dreams. Together, it can be this way. Ontario Liberals, it can be this way. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup.
And that's the Liberal MPP for Scarborough-Guildwood, Mitzie Hunter, finishing her speech here at the International Centre.